This is John Kohler with GrowingYourGreens.com. Today I have a very exciting episode for you. Today is Thanksgiving and I want to wish all my new and old viewers happy Thanksgiving and have the best Thanksgiving ever. And what I want to talk about today is two things. Well, first I want to talk about Thanksgiving. What is Thanksgiving? Well, it's about giving thanks. And back in the olden days, the reason for Thanksgiving was the pilgrims that came to the United States were celebrating the harvest. Yes, that's right, the harvest. And how many American families today are truly celebrating their harvest every Thanksgiving? Well, Thanksgiving gets to be just one of those holidays. You get a couple few days off, you get to go Black Friday shopping, and you get a turkey to eat from dinner from the grocery store, and then you come home and you give thanks for whatever it is in your life. But it's probably not the harvest in most families' cases in the United States today. So we've kind of, in my opinion, getting away from the real true meaning of Thanksgiving. So besides giving thanks for the harvest, there's many other things that you should be thankful for, in my opinion. The biggest thing that I'm thankful for today is waking up today, because some people don't wake up. Another thing that I'm thankful for is that I have a front yard garden, and for all the people that have made it possible for me to do this, including people that have grown all the different seeds of all the different plants that I'm growing, from people that are propagating and keeping these plants alive, from the nurseries that, you know, I bought many of the starts from that allows me to grow the food, from the compost company that's provided me excellent high quality compost, to Azomite and Gaia Green who make the rock dust that I put into my garden, to companies like Plant Success that offer me the mycorrhiza so that my plants can grow better. But overall, I'm just happy for nature and that I could grow my own garden. Another reason for this video is to talk about what do you do when the stores close? Because on Thanksgiving and days like Christmas, in general, most stores are closed. Maybe some grocery stores want to, you know, up their bottom line and they're open for a few hours in the morning. So the day before Thanksgiving and the morning of Thanksgiving, stores are, especially grocery stores, it's one of the worst places to be because there's really long lines and you don't want to be shopping there. But what does most of America do on Thanksgiving if they didn't go shopping before? Well, they eat something that they have already in their house because they're not going to be buying anything from the grocery store because they're closed, or they're going to go out to dinner at a restaurant that does happen to be open, and most of them are closed. But that just brings up the point, what does most of America do when the grocery stores are closed? Well, most Americans don't grow their own food. They have no source of food, so they're dependent on the stores. So I want to encourage everybody to grow at least a portion of your food so when the stores close, you could still be eating. And actually, it's Thanksgiving later, a little bit later in the afternoon. I think the stores are closed now. And if people didn't buy whatever they needed at the stores, they're not eating. In my case, I'm going to show you guys what I could be eating today if I wanted to and go around and harvest a whole bunch of stuff out of my yard today that I'm actually going to eat for dinner and also start the process, because the Thanksgiving usually pretty much coincides with when it gets too cold for all my summer crops. So that's the time that those are coming out and new stuff is going in. So let's go ahead and give you a quick tour of all the different things and varieties of things that I'm growing that I'm going to be eating later today and tonight for my Thanksgiving meal. So let's get harvesting. Now, no Thanksgiving would be complete without pumpkins and pumpkin pie. So they have pumpkin pie pumpkins, but I'm not growing them. I'm growing these guys. These are called kakai pumpkins. These are hullless pumpkins, so you can use the flesh much like a regular pumpkin, cook it up, make a pumpkin pie out of it. But with these pumpkins, actually the seeds are hullless, so they're green seeds that taste delicious just right out of the pumpkin itself. So check my other videos for a video on the kakais. But we're gonna harvest this one today. This is the largest one that I've grown this year. And man, this thing is quite stocky. Whoa, and there it is. Didn't you have to cut it off? Whoa, this thing is so heavy. It's like probably as big as my head. Normally these guys don't actually get all that large, but this is gonna make a delicious pumpkin tonight for tonight's dinner. I'm probably gonna harvest all the fresh seeds out of it and use those. So another crop that I'm really thankful for having on Thanksgiving are fresh tomatoes. So I've been picking some of these tomatoes over here, and oh, here's one I really want to pick. Where is it? It's hiding from me. Right here. This one's called a green zebra. This is definitely one of my favorites, and I still have some tomatoes. You can see my vines are getting really trash because we did have a light freeze or frost, but a lot of the tomatoes are still ripening up, but they're going to be coming to an end real soon. So I'm thankful for tomatoes that are going to go into my tonight's dinner. So with the cold Thanksgiving weather, most of my summer crops are no longer with us, such as these cucumbers behind us. But I like to use nature as my refrigerator, once again, instead of the grocery store and instead of the refrigerator inside my home. I'd like to use nature as a refrigerator. I just like to let the cucumbers, in this case, hang until I'm ready to pick them or until the plants literally freeze out. We did have a light frost, which got all the vines. And if the frost is really hard, it's going to freeze the cucumbers and the cucumbers will no longer be good. But because it wasn't that hard, the cucumbers are fine, but the vines are gone. So now we got to pick these and use them all. So I'm probably going to juice this and make it into a lacto-fermented lemon cucumber juice. And I have a video on that. And man, that stuff, I just had some last night. It's so delicious. The stuff I made was probably about 20 days old when I bottled it, and then probably another 2 weeks old, so maybe a total of 4 weeks, and it was nice and smooth and fizzy. So we're gonna harvest some of these, and we're gonna make some more lacto-fermented cucumber juice that'll probably be ready for Christmas. So another thing that's doing really well in my garden are these guys, and this is actually why I like this plant so much, because when everything else is just not making it because it's gotten too cold, like my tomatoes are definitely on the way out, these guys here, the lychee tomatoes, they've only just begun to start growing. Now, if it does get too cold, these guys aren't going to make it. But check it out. I mean, this guy's still flowering. Here's some beautiful flowers right here. These are definitely beautiful flowers. And it's still making fruit. Here's some green fruit. But check it out. This thing is just loaded with all kind of fruit on it. And these are called the lychee tomatoes, also in the Solanaceae family. And I have this whole plant and it has just so many little berries on it. Now these aren't full-size tomatoes, they're like little cherry-sized tomatoes, but these guys pack a really good punch. They have a nice flavor, and you gotta wait till they're completely ripe. So let's see here. I'm gonna go ahead and find one. So here's one that's completely ripe. We're gonna go ahead and be careful to pick it, and this plant does have thorns on it, or a little stickers on it. And we're just gonna go ahead and pop this off. And there it is. Nothing better than lychee tomatoes on Thanksgiving. So another crop I'm really thankful for today on Thanksgiving are my fajoas or pineapple guavas. You can see here I've collected like a whole little box full, and this is definitely gonna be a nice dessert fruit. Gonna eat these fruits for dessert or maybe even pre-Thanksgiving dinner. Oh, they just smell so good. So the next crop I'm going to be harvesting for Thanksgiving is related to the tomato. It's in the Solanaceae or nightshade family, more similar to the tomatillo, but actually it's something totally different. It's actually called the Cape Gooseberry, also called the Incan berry, and also called the Poha berry. And it's a really nice plant. You can see this is how it grows. It has these little Chinese lantern looking fruit pods. They're green when they're unripe. But when they turn ripe, generally they fall from the plant. If they don't fall, they'll get ripe on the plant like this, and they'll actually turn to like a tan color. And then at that point, you can just basically pick it off. And once you got it, what you're gonna do is you're gonna just open it up to reveal a nice little berry. So this berry will be green when it's not ripe, and then turn this color when it's optimally ripe. And actually, these are optimally ripe. That's so good. So amazing. I'm going to sit here and eat some of these for a while as my mid-afternoon snack. So another crop that I'm harvesting for Thanksgiving is the Native American runner beans. So these ones may have actually been fed for Thanksgiving back in the day. And these guys have nice, beautiful blooms. I don't know if I have any blooms left. Maybe on the other side. Let me show you guys that. Aha! Here we go. Here's a runner bean bloom. Nice and pretty. These do make small edible beans. You could actually pick and eat like green beans. They're actually quite delicious. I might say at least as delicious as a sugar snap peas when they're young. When they do get older, they look like this. And this is when you can cook these up and eat them. And if you let them go further, they're going to turn into this right here. And they just get these pods. Like this, they dry on the vine, I'll then go ahead and pull it off, and then you could go ahead and rip it open. And you could see the runner beans inside. So this one has two little black beans. And here's a little whole container of the beans that I just harvested. They come in different colors. They got the black ones, and they got the purple ones with black dots, and then they got the almost black ones with purple spots. Man, these are just like one of the cutest and coolest beans. And yes, they are edible, but I'm not eating them for dinner tonight. These ones are too valuable for me to eat for dinner. So I'm gonna save these for the seed stock so I can continue to grow these. These are a perennial crop here in Northern California. I like it a lot. I literally planted them last year. I cut them back when it finally did freeze hard. This did survive the light freeze because we just had one. And it's still growing prolifically. It's doing very well. But if once you have a hard freeze, it's not gonna make it. I'll cut it back and leave the root. It's a nice tuberous carrot looking like root under the ground. Leave that all winter and it shoots back up in the spring. So I've strategically am growing it over my arbor, and it fills up the arbor every single year. Looks beautiful and yields lots of delicious food. So the next crop we're gonna talk about is another native North American crop. And this is a crop the Indians were eating before the Europeans came to America. And it's right here. We've already cut down the main stalks. I've kind of left these to show me where they were. And you can see some of them poking out. These are called the sunchokes, also called Jerusalem artichokes. We could go ahead and just remove this main stalk and you could see them all kind of come up. But if I just dig down a little bit, we're gonna find all these little tubers. Wow, that's a nice little cute one. But they get a lot bigger and there's gonna be some big, huge ones down in here. Let me see, I'll go ahead and uproot this guy. Oh, that's gonna be good for dinner here. Man, that's a big one, check it out. Oh, I'm caught on my little stainless steel grid thing here. All right, there it is. One big, nice sunchoke. Get some of that dirt off. All right, here we go. So once again, this is the sunchoke. This is in the sunflower family. It grows a nice big sunflower-like plant with small flowers that smell amazing, but actually don't taste good. Sunchokes here are edible. You could cook them on up, but I suggest you don't cook your sunchokes. They're just so delicious to eat raw. They have a flavor reminiscent of jicama, if you know what that tastes like. Just take your sunchokes, wash off the dirt really good. Slice them into small chips, dip them in some guacamole, some salsa, or other dressing, and man, they're just so delicious. So be sure to be eating this tonight for my Thanksgiving dinner because these are native to America. So one of the things I'm grateful for is that I still have peppers on Thanksgiving. You can see a whole little box of them right here, and check this plant out. I've been waiting all year for these guys to ripen up. And now, I mean, look at this. I just have peppers galore. So now I'm gonna pick all these and I'm gonna eat some tonight and also dehydrate more peppers. Yum. One of the reasons why I like growing my own food because I could be assured that when I pick the produce, it's at the ripeness level I desire. And I desire things as ripe as possible because that's when they taste the best. And also there's the most nutrition in the plant. So what we're looking at here is my pomegranate tree. And here's a ripe pomegranate. And how do you know when the pomegranate's ripe? Well, you just gotta use your eyes. So let me show you this. Check it out. When the pomegranate's ripe, the pomegranate literally will open up on the tree because what it does, it opens up and then it lets all the seeds drop or the birds come and eat the seeds. And man, that's one deep, dark, rich pomegranate. Let's go ahead and cut that guy off there. And check it out. These are like one of the darkest pomegranates I've ever seen. Have you ever seen one when they're that dark? Wow, these are gonna be super delicious. It's also the best pomegranate I've ever tasted in my life. So the last thing that I'm grateful for today that I'm gonna share with you guys, because I'm grateful for a lot of other things, are that I still have figs on my tree and some of them are actually ripening before they're going bad. And let me see, I think this guy is gonna be pretty good here. And let's check it out on the inside. Well, not quite as ripe as it could be. But I think this guy is still definitely edible. Nothing like a fig for Thanksgiving. In any case, I want to remind you guys that Thanksgiving is all about being thankful for the harvest. And in this day and age, not many people are harvesting their crops to eat for Thanksgiving, which I think is really sad. So I'm going to encourage everybody out there to grow a garden or at least grow part of your own food. It's easy. Anybody could do it. And you could even sprout in the kitchen in wintertime. So today, Thanksgiving is thought more than just being thankful for our food, but just being thankful for something in general. So please, everybody that watches this video, post down below what you are thankful for today. Once again, my name is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We'll see you next time. And remember, keep on growing.